Hello, everyone.
Welcome to the iCloud Go. Have you ever encountered this situation? You just bought a secondhand iPhone, but it's locked and asks for the original Apple ID? Or maybe you forgot your own Apple ID and now your iPhone is completely unusable. Don't worry. Today, we'll show you four reliable methods to successfully unlock your iPhone. Important notice, bypassing iCloud lock on a device you don't own without permission is illegal. Method 1. Ask the original owner to remove iCloud lock. If you purchased a second-hand iPhone, the most official and straightforward method is to ask the original owner to remove the activation lock remotely via iCloud. First, ask the original owner to visit iCloud.com, find on a computer or another phone, and log into their Apple ID. Next, they should locate the locked device in the list. Then, select Remove this device and follow the on-screen instructions. Once completed, go back to your iPhone, restart the setup process, and the activation lock will be gone. Now you can set up your iPhone as a new device. This method is officially supported by Apple and ensures iCloud functions remain intact. However, it only works if you can contact the original owner. Method 2, unlock via IMEI remote service. If you can't reach the original owner, you might be able to unlock the iPhone using its IMEI number. Light up the screen when your iPhone is black. At the bottom right, you can see an exclamation mark icon. Tap it. You can then see your device IMEI here. Then, look for an official carrier service or a reputable unlocking website that offers IMEI-based unlocking. Submit an IMEI unlock request and wait for the verification and processing. If approved, your iPhone will be unlocked and ready for activation. This restores access to the device. Method 3, unlock using 4U key. If you forgot your Apple ID and password, you can use a professional unlocking tool like Tenorshare 4U key to remove the activation lock. Use the link in the video description to download and install 4U key on your computer. Launch 4U key and connect your iPhone to the computer. Select Remove iCloud activation lock, then click Start. Your device will enter recovery mode automatically. You'll then need to follow the instructions to put your iPhone in DFU mode to begin the jailbreak. After clicking Start, press and hold the volume down and side buttons at the same time. After 5 seconds, release the side button but keep holding volume down. Wait another 10 seconds and your iPhone will enter DFU mode and begin jailbreaking. After the jailbreak is complete, your device will enter recovery mode again. Then you need to operate your device into DFU mode again. The software will now start removing the activation lock. Just wait for the process to finish. When done, your device will restart and you can go through the setup process again. This time you won't see the activation lock screen. That's it. However, this method will cause some of the functions of the device to be limited, so you need to be careful when using it. Method 4, use DNS bypass for temporary access. If you just need temporary access to certain functions on your iPhone, you can try the DNS bypass method. On the Wi-Fi page, press and hold the side button to bring up more settings. Then select WLAN settings. An exclamation point icon will appear next to the connected networks. Tap it and scroll down to find DNS settings. Then enter the DNS address to modify the servers based on your region. Tap Save when you're done entering. Tap back and next. Then go back to the Wi-Fi page and tap Connected Networks. This will open a limited use interface where you can browse the web and access some apps. This method is easy to use and can be helpful in emergencies, but it does not permanently unlock your iPhone and you won't have full functionality. Okay, these are the four ways to unlock an iPhone locked to owner. Each method has its own usage scenario, whether you are using an official solution or a third-party tool. If you are facing this problem, I hope this video will help you. Have any questions? Leave it in the comments and we'll do our best to answer it for you. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tech tips. See you next time.